I caught it a multiplayer battle royale shooter within 1 month, and in this video I will show you how far I've come. Okay, first things first. When you open the game, you see the start menu.
Wow, JD, that's so nice.
Thank you. And yeah, I didn't manage to create a logo in time. Just imagine a super fancy logo for a game. The game even has a settings menu where you can make all the adjustments to make the game to your liking. Whether graphic settings, sound design, 3D sound, anti-aliasing, screen resolution, game world settings, everything. When you click on start, you're automatically logged into a server provided by Unity, the sponsor of today. Here you can either create a host server and host the game yourself, or you can just join a game like this colleague here. Yes, I have to play with myself because I don't have any friends. You know, I miss her and... When all players are ready for the game, we can press the ready button and the host can then start the game. And off we go. We can walk around and you can see their animation for the right arm isn't that perfect yet. And I haven't found the perfect animation yet, but I think it's cute how he wobbles his head a bit while walking. We can open the treasure chest and see what loot we get. The loot can either be a weapon, which is ranked according to different tiers, or ammunition for the weapon. So far, I have only two weapons, a scar and a sniper. The weapons can not only be used to shoot objects in the world that are currently interfering, no, you can actually use them to attack other players.
Nice.
Makes sense in a shooter, I guess. If the opponent has no more lives, he is not eliminated like in a normal battle royale game. No, he simply gets a new spawn. The simple reason for this is that the map is way too small. The battle royale mechanic is still built in. There is a zone that gets smaller and smaller, but however, I have switched it off for this video. If you want to find out more about that, just click on the video in the description. At the top right corner, you can see a mini-map that always shows where you are. Again, it's not very useful to have a minimap because the map is just too small, but the mechanics are still quite interesting. Yeah, and that was it actually. I managed that in 1 month. It doesn't seem like a lot when you look at the content, but all the systems behind it and especially the networking make it very difficult to make good progress quickly. Especially when you consider that I only spent half an hour to an hour a day on the project, but it actually looks pretty decent, I think. Don't forget to like the video if you liked it and subscribe to the channel if you want to learn more about game dev and don't want to miss any more videos. By the way, the code for my project can be found for free in the video description. Bye!